Now, here are some stocks to watch out for. We are monitoring shares of Reddit after it announced a deal with OpenAI for the use of its data to train ChatGPT's language model. Reddit shares surged 16% on the news. Also in focus, shares of Sainsbury's, which has partnered with Microsoft to use artificial intelligence to enhance physical and online shopping experience. Shares of the British grocer are slightly up. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Swiss luxury group Richemont after the company reported record full-year sales and announced a new CEO. Richemont shares climbed 6%. Malaysian markets ended the week how it started, on a mixed note. That's after fresh signs of stalled recovery in China. Data showed retail sales in the world's second largest economy grew at its slowest pace in 2 years. New home prices also fell at the fast clip in over 9 years. But sentiment was soothed after China announced sweeping measures to stabilize the property sector, including allowing local governments to buy some apartments and relaxing mortgage rules. The Hong Kong Hang Seng Mainland Properties Index surged more than 5% on the news, but at least one economist is unconvinced by the moves.
So we are now seeing an extended crisis, which primarily revolves around the balance sheet of property developers. And with that in mind, I think the better way is really to directly nationalize the troubled developers or ask some other financially more healthier enterprises to directly take over them. Yeah, so this way you can, as a government, you can inject home buyers' confidence with a state guarantee. If the government initiative is about to further fully absorb the excess housing stock, it will likely require many trillions of RMB to really purchase these housing stocks. Yeah, but it looks like all of the central bank support or some other sort of fiscal support is only likely to amount to hundreds of billions of RMB. Yeah, so which is a far cry from the actual amount of money needed.
Meanwhile, here at home, the local bourse closed lower on last-minute profit-taking. Despite that, the main index snapped a six-week weekly losing streak.
I continue to expect a range of between 6.4 to around 6,800. One thing that we need to understand that the first quarter growth numbers are actually good. So okay. This is actually highlighting that the economy can withstand higher interest rates. I think the only challenge really is trying to bring down that inflation expectation so that consumer spending will eventually lift off. Once the market becomes convinced that the biggest portion of our economy, which is spending, starts coming back, then most likely we could break out above the 6.8 and probably retest the 7,000.
The Philippine Central Bank has launched a probe on employees who appeared to have falsified attendance records. It did not disclose further details, but the statement follows reports two BSP officials had hired ghost employees who do not really work at the central bank but receive salaries and benefits. The BSP says it is firm in its commitment to ensure any erring employee will be held accountable and uphold integrity in the organization. BSP officials rank among the highest paid in the government. Employees there are also generally hired after rigorous screening.